Hello, this week we are going to do a portrait of a singer named Karl Sprouse. I hope I am pronouncing him correctly. It's a very well lit face where the light source is on the right hand side of the face with long hairs. So let's keep the copy in portrait form. And the first step is plan the portrait, we already know that. Then we'll start from the eye close to the nose. In this case, I have started with the left eye, and there are some shadow marks near the eye. We have done that also. That gives us the reference point for the nose. While doing the nose, I'll also do the hair that is coming on the nose. Then I'll go and do the second eye. All 1, 2, 3, 4 has to be accurate. While doing the second eye, compare the position from the first eye and the nose. Then we'll do the U below the nose and the lips. Is it open lip, tighty lip? After that, we'll do a check. If everything is fine, we'll rub the outer face line. So I hope till now, till this step, you will not have a problem. But do it accurately. Then we'll start with the face line closer to the eye. In this case, it is the right side face line. While I'm doing this face line, please compare the lines with the features. I have done the same thing. The line should be in accordance with the eye, the nose and the chin and the lips. Then we'll do the chin portion and the second face line. While doing the top part of the face line, the hair is coming in the picture, so we'll also draw the hair. The hair will join from the hair that is coming on the nose. Then just draw the ears, they are part of the face line. And finally the hair, the outer part of the hair, the neck and the t-shirt part. After this, again do a second check where you check each internal inside features and the face lines, chin, the hair and the shoulder and stuff. Then we start shading. The right-handed students should start shading from the left side, the left-handed students should start shading from the right side. Since I am right-handed, I am starting as red to shade from the eye. I concentrate on the eye, and then I have started shading the portions near to the eye. Then I'll continue with the portions around the eye and the face on the left side. Don't leave any extra stroke, and the shading should be smooth. Then I will continue shading the nose and the forehead on the left side. Then the area under the nose, that is the U portion, and the chin. Please note there is a white highlight near the face line too and the chin, so keep that in mind. Then the lips, start shading from the top lip, then the inside portion and the bottom lip. I'll shade the right side part of the forehead, very light shading, and the right side and the right eye and the shading below the eye. A very light shading on the right side of the face. The right side of the face is basically white. Then the shading of the neck and the chin region. And the approach is dark medium light without leaving any extra strokes. Then there are some beauty spots on his face, so I've just drawn that, approximately 4. Now, how to do the hair? First, lightly with the pencil, we'll get the direction of the hair. While doing this, please put a page on the face so that the face isn't smudged. Lightly just get the direction of the hair. Keep your hand very light. You're not shading right now. Once you've got the direction, then from the left side, start shading dark, medium, light. Apply the darker tone wherever you see, smudged with the medium tone, and for the lighter tone, just leave it as white gap. Following the direction which we have already done, do the hair slowly. It takes time in drawing the hair, but the approach is very simple and mechanical. Get the direction and do the shading dark medium, leaving the light tone. When that is done, shed the t-shirt and dust crisscross background from the bottom. Then this is the final sketch. I've just darkened the background a bit on the left hand side, just get to the chin a bit, and that's it. Please note, this is not a 100% accurate portrait. Since some of the students are doing this portrait for the first time, I have kept it around 95% accuracy. All the best.